Kia ora, good evening. He says he was just horsing around, but pulling a woman's ponytail is proving highly embarrassing for the Prime Minister.
John Key's had to apologise after an Auckland waitress revealed he tugged her ponytail on several occasions, even after she asked him to stop. Some are calling his actions weird, while a top employment law expert says it's a classic case of bullying. Here's political reporter Katie Bradford.
On the campaign trail, he admired this little girl's plaits and had some advice.
The boys don't pull it, do they? No. That's good. We don't want that to happen, do we?
Not taking his own advice saw John Key face some awkward questions in Los Angeles today about his behaviour in an Auckland cafe early last year.
We have lots of fun and games there, and there's always lots of practical jokes and things. And it's a very warm, friendly relationship.
But a waitress who One News understands works at this popular Par Now eatery certainly doesn't believe it was just horseplay. She told the left-wing Daily Blog the first time he pulled her hair, she thought the Prime Minister was just being playful and jolly. She said she shouldn't have to tell the Prime Minister, "I don't like it when he pulls my hair. Talk about stating the obvious." She said he told her her ponytail was tantalising.
When I realised she took offence by that, I just sort of immediately went back, gave her some wine, apologised, said I was terribly sorry.
It's weird, but it's totally unbecoming of the Prime Minister.
John Key is often praised for his relaxed approach with the public, but it appears to have backfired this time. Professor Tim Bentley helped devise procedures for workplace bullying and says this is a classic example.
If this had been a regular punter coming into the cafe for a cup of coffee and was repeatedly doing this, I think there's little doubt that the employer would protect the employee and ask the person to stop or even maybe bar them from the cafe.
And a hospitality worker says she wasn't surprised to hear about the incident.
Not that I would expect this of the Prime Minister per se or at all, but more just that this seems to go with being in hospo. Quite regularly I've had male customers just cross a line with me where I feel uncomfortable.
An uncomfortable time now for the Prime Minister.
Look, yep, okay, I accept that that was inappropriate, and so I've apologised for that.
Making a highly embarrassing apology as he jets off to Gallipoli.
Katie joins us now, live now. This might seem harmless to some people, Katie, but it could be hugely embarrassing on the global stage, couldn't it?
Yeah, look, this is the worst timing for the Prime Minister. This story is already making headlines around the world. It's in The Guardian, the BBC and the New York Times. And it comes as the Prime Minister heads to Gallipoli, not only for those Anzac Day commemorations, but also to sit down with world leaders. And if they read the story, they'll be wondering what on earth is going on in New Zealand. Look, this is where that relaxed, playful attitude of the Prime Minister that a lot of people like, this is where it perhaps can harm him. He clearly went a bit far in this case. And because of these commemorations, because he's had to stop, he's stopping in LA on his way to Turkey, he's had to rush to the media and apologise and explain just what went on his way there. He knew he needed to nip it in the bud, though. He knew he needed to do it now, because the last thing he wants when he's heading into those commemorations is this hanging over his head. Look, I think in terms of where to from here, I don't think we'll see any action. I don't think this woman will take action at all, but certainly it's a highly embarrassing incident for the Prime Minister.
Live from Parliament, Katie Bradford, thank you very much.